Good morning, students, and welcome to your English language class. I hope you all are doing well. In this video, we'll be reading a very beautiful poem, The Violet. Now, this poem has been written by Jane Taylor, the famous poetess who has also written some of the remarkable poems. Children's all-time favorite nursery rhyme, Twinkle, Twinkle, Little Star, was also composed by Jane Taylor. Now, through this poem, Jane Taylor wants to emphasize the need of being humble and polite. We should learn modesty and contentment from violets, that despite their dazzling beauty, are content in their humble belonging and make this world lovable. It's a very beautiful poem, students. As you know, violet is a beautiful flower and it's bluish purple in color. Now, as you can see here, this poem has four stanzas. First, we'll read the poem and then I'll explain all the stanzas one by one. Down in a green and shady bed, a modest violet grew. Its stalk was bent, it hung its head as if to hide from view. And yet it was a lovely flower, its colors bright and fair. It might have graced a rosy bower instead of hiding there. Yet there it was content to bloom in modest tints arrayed, and there diffused its sweet perfume within the silent shade. Then let me to the valley go, this pretty flower to see, that I may also learn to grow in sweet humility. Now, as you can see, there are four stanzas in this poem, and now let us go through all these stanzas one by one. Now, this is our first stanza. Down in a green and shady bed. A green and shady bed refers to shady green grass where this violet flower is growing. A modest violet grew. Modest means humble, a very down-to-earth person or being. Now, here The violet has been referred as modest, a very humble thing. Its stalk was bent, it hung its head. Stalk means stem of the flower. Now, its stalk was bent, it hung its head. जो violet flower है हमारा, वो ऐसा लग रहा है जैसे उसने अपने सर को झुकाया हुआ है. उसका जो stem है वो bent है और ऐसा लग रहा है जैसे उसने अपने सर को झुकाया हुआ है. As if to hide from view, और ये भी लग रहा है कि जैसे उसने अपने आप को दुनिया से छुपा रखा है ताकि उसे कोई देख ना सके. It's hiding from everyone, it doesn't want it to be seen. Now, down in a green and shady bed, a modest violet grew. Its stalk was bent, it hung its head as if to hide from view. This is our first stanza. Now, this is our second stanza. And yet it was a lovely flower, its color bright and fair. It might have graced a rosy bower instead of hiding there. Now, the first line here, and yet it was a lovely flower, means although it was a very lovely flower, which is very colorful and very bright and fair, it might have graced a rosy bower. इसका मतलब है कि वो अगर जो violet हमारा flower है वो अगर चाहे तो it can grace a rosy bower. Bower means a pleasant shady place in a garden. कि वो एक बहुत ही सुंदर garden का हिस्सा बन सकता है. It's that colorful, it's that bright and it's that lovely. And instead of hiding there, it shouldn't be hiding here. It should be in a very lovely and very pleasant garden, but it's hiding here. So this is our second stanza. As you can see, let me read it out once again for you. And yet it was a lovely flower, its colors bright and fair. It might have graced a rosy bower instead of hiding there. ओके स्टूडेंट्स, सो हमारी जो ये पोइटस है जेन टेलर, वो इस स्टैंजा में ये कहना चाहती हैं कि ऑल दो वायलेट जो है इट्स अ वेरी ब्यूटिफुल फ्लावर, इंस्टेड ऑफ शोइंग ऑफ इट्स हाइडिंग देयर. नाउ दिस इज आवर थर्ड स्टैंजा. येट देयर इट वॉज कंटेंट टू ब्लूम इन मॉडेस्ट टेंट्स अरेड एंड देयर डिफ्यूज्ड इट्स स्वीट परफ्यूम विद इन द साइलेंट शेड. Yet there it was content to bloom. That means it was satisfied to bloom in a place which is very ordinary and it's not that good. In modest tints arrayed. That means a color or shade of humbleness is arranged. And there diffused its sweet perfume. Diffused means spread. It is spreading its sweet perfume within the silent shade. Now, within the silent shade means, although it is blooming in a very ordinary bed of grass, it's not blooming in a beautiful garden, it is spreading its sweet fragrance with all its modesty and its humbleness. So, we must learn from a violet to be humble and to be modest. If we have a quality, we should not compare ourselves with others in a superior way. We should be grateful to God that whatever qualities we have been given by the God, we should be grateful, we should be thankful to God for all of them. But we should not show off, we should not be proudy. हमें घमंड नहीं करना चाहिए अपने पर, हमें बिल्कुल ही down to earth रहना चाहिए. हमारी जो भी qualities हैं, हमें उनके लिए शुक्रिया करना चाहिए भगवान का. नाउ दिस इज आवर फोर्थ एंड लास्ट स्टैंजा ऑफ द पोएम. देन लेट मी टू द वैली गो दैट आई मे ऑल्सो लर्न टू ग्रो इन स्वीट ह्यूमिलिटी. नाउ द पोएटिस वॉन्ट्स टू गो टू दिस वैली टू सी दिस प्रिटी फ्लावर द वायलेट so that she can also learn to grow in sweet humility. Humility means the quality of not thinking that you are better than other people or being down to earth. बेटा humility मतलब जब आप अपने आप को दूसरों से ज़्यादा superior नहीं समझते हैं, अपने आप अपने ऊपर घमंड नहीं करते हैं और एक बड़ी ही साधारण सी simple life जीते हैं. That is what is called as humility. Then we all must learn to live in humility, to be humble and to be modest. We should never show off, we should never be proud of ourselves, proud in the sense in a wrong manner. हमें अपने ऊपर घमंड नहीं करना चाहिए. We must have self-confidence, हमें खुद पे विश्वास होना चाहिए लेकिन अपने ऊपर घमंड कभी भी नहीं होना चाहिए. Proud और pride जो है अलग अलग चीज़ें होती हैं. प्राउड मतलब घमंड करना एंड टू टेक प्राइड ऑन वन सेल्फ मतलब अपने ऊपर नाज होना कि हाँ मैंने ये काम किया है और एंड आई वॉज केपेबल ऑफ डूइंग दिस. तो हमें वायलेट से ये सारी चीज़ें सीखने को मिलती हैं. नाउ दिस इज योर होमवर्क. यू हैव टू राइट द वर्ड मीनिंग्स. फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू हैव टू राइट द पोएम इन योर फेयर नोटबुक. देन यू मस्ट राइट द न्यू वर्ड्स और वर्ड मीनिंग. And then you have to answer the questions. Thank you for watching this video.